die? Think you can dodge? Just try. Perfect mayhem!
No mercy! Wounds that will shoot us cut in the flesh!
Behold the arts of my ancestors!
Dragonstyle! Aaron!
Their release! The light of virtue! The dark of vice! Blinding chaos! Chaos bloom! Now, with a single breath, they appear! Here they come! There's no stopping them now! Good catch!
I'm very excited now. What you want to do?
Worthless slavery!
The future!
You got one wind in the air!
Hello, welcome to this video. This is going to be a guide for this game, how to fight and everything, what everything means. I'll try my best to explain everything. So do remember, this video could get lengthy, so don't expect a guide for this to be very short. Okay, that's enough time wasting. Let's just understand what is going on. Once you gain all 6 characters, I'm currently at the point where I gain the 6th character. Here you can see that you gain 2 subsection. These are substitute section. What this means that these 2 people will not be in the battle unless you switch with any one of this in the current battle situation. So do remember whom you put over here and whom you have at the rest 4. Now the BG will unlock. What is this? The BG will unlock after a certain amount of time in the game. So if you are watching this video at the very early in the game, you will not get this section, and you don't have to worry because it will not affect you in any way. Okay, so let's understand what this combos and everything is that might have left you confused. These attacks cost SG, Souls Point, the points you see in the battle, 3 points, 4 points, 5 points, depending upon how the battle leads. 5 means it will cost 5 Souls Points. 1 soul has 30 points. The one dot you see while battling, 1 soul has 30 points. So remember that when you are putting very high number of, like here, 29 soul points, it will take 1 whole point. Then Hellgate here costs 42, so partially 1.5 points. So that's not important. That's just the amount you should require, keep in your mind while putting the combos. Now, how to have chaining combos? Every combo you see, no matter wherever you start, you will see 2 things. The stun, I mean the stun can be anything, there's the status effects that attack can cause. As you can see, burn, poison, absorb HP, stun, these are different for different characters, so remember that. So those means that those attack can cause those effects on enemies, and those effects, if they land and do poison or stun or burn the enemies, you will gain 1 extra soul point. Like when you start a battle, you will have 3 max soul points, and if you inflict any status effects, you will gain 1 extra point from the enemy. So that's how you gain and lose your points. If the enemy attacks you and you get stunned or any status effect, remember that you will lose your point. So that's basically how you gain and lose your points, so keep that in mind. Now what are the next one that you see? These are the next chain combo that you can perform. These are mostly the spell one. You have to wait to cast the spells, so don't use them in a battle where you are the one targeted by the enemy. Do this when you are in the long range, or leave them for the AI to perform. So let's understand this. Like tempo over here chains to clear path, which I have here, then it leads to poison, then it leads to wind stance, lance. So that's how this basically works for any character. Here I have Shockwave, Slash, which leads to Shooting Star, Inferno Bloom, or Witch's Fury. Why this is important? This is important because it will chain directly into that move without having to wait. If you play any fighting games anyway, you will see that there are combos, specific combos you have to perform one after the other. If you move from one, let's just from wide, you just move to Shooting Star by pressing X, then you press B, then you press A to form a combo. Do remember that between that interval of your next animation, the enemy might get a chance to attack you. That's how mostly fighting game works. So, and here is also same mechanics. If you chain one move to another, you can perform the combo very nicely without the enemy affecting you. If you move from one to another, there is a chance that the enemy might attack you in between that animation. Hope I'm clear. So that's basically the RT is. You can experiment with it as long as you want. In a battle system, you have to check the enemy's weakness, which, like you can see here, is the attack type. Fire and wind, it's the attack attribute, and it will lead to burn. So remember all this. This one means it is no elemental one. The star one means this is earth and this is water. This red one means fire and this one means wind. So hope you're clear with that. Those attack will do extra damage to the specific enemy's weakness. So I believe I covered all the menu related one. If you got any doubt, let me know. And if you got any equipment doubt, like, let's just understand this. this one means your basic attacks, the martial art ones and all the ones that you do, your fist fighting and sword striking one. This one means the magic attack, magic ones. These are the defense, magic defense. This is the main one, focus. What focus means that let's just understand focus. Focus means how often it will cast your status element on the enemy. More focus means you have a higher chance of inflicting the enemy with your status, thus gaining more soul points. Hope I'm clear until this point. If you got any doubts until this point, do comment below. For now, we'll go into the combat directly. In case you are on PC, man, I'm talking too much, my mouth is going all dry. Sorry if my voice gets different. My mouth is getting so dry. So this is the battle. These are the keys for my gamepad. If you're on PC, watch this video, watch this, whatever keys you are, remember the keys you have for these things. When switching target, you have to select left button, the guard button, I believe space is the guard button for PC. Select that and choose your direction keys to switch between the characters. Alright, now let's just start with the fighting, how we do. In case you miss anything, you can select the help section here and find things out. I'm going to call soul gaze soul points because it's just easier to understand. Here I'm having Velvet and Eleanor sub characters. To switch between sub characters, you will require BG points. You will unlock those BG points as you progress through the story, in case you're new and I'm wondering what the hell BG points are. These are the main four characters which will present at the start of a battle. To get these two characters, you have to switch between them. And this can be anything, it's not like it's fixed. Switch between any character you want. I'm just putting the example over here. What I will cover here is now how to switch between characters in game and during the fights. It's very basic, but it'll still someone wants to know. Sorry for the mess up. And between the substitute characters, When you start the match, everyone will have 3 soul points. As you could see, everyone is having 3 soul points, even the enemy. The boss has 5 just like us. The lower enemies or normal enemies only have 3. The boss one has 5. How do steal and soul point, and how enemies steal your soul points is actually very same way, applying status effects as I mentioned before. Every attack you do has some kind of status really, attached to it, like it can stun, it can burn, it can paralyze, any of those sorts. And if your enemy if you manage to do that to enemy, you will gain their soul point, and if the enemy does that to you, the enemy will gain your soul points. Now, is there any drawback to taking your soul points away from you? Of course there is. Remember, I have 3 soul points. That means I can only do 3 attacks. 1, 2, 3. Even if I try to do another attack, it won't happen because I only have 3 points, as you could see. So 3 attacks. As you could see, my what's his name, man? Aizen. Aizen still has 2 blue points, so that I can still attack the enemy. But since the max soul points I have is 3, so I can only do 3 combos in one time. Again, only 3 can be done. Now, to increase that, you will have to, again, as I said, sorry, you have to cause some effects on the enemy, like stun, paralyze, or something, which will give you more soul points. In case you don't want to do that, you can always switch between your sub characters, as I said. Take a look here. Aizen has 3, and the BG point is 5. Sorry, I will switch between Velvet. For some reason, whenever I switch between Velvet, she gets 4 points randomly, 4 points. I don't know if it's a set bonus or something, I don't know. But I will go back to Aizen now. As you could see, every time I switch between character, the chain to different combo. This can be helpful if in case you want to chain multiple combos. So keep that in mind, in case you want to chain combos, you can switch between characters and do those easily. So as I was saying, Aizen already had 5 a switch, so it became 4 now, and thus that point went to your soul points. He had 3 first, now I have 4. Now let's try to do my 4 combo and let's see if I'm successful now. 1, 2. A fucking bullshit, I got stunned and now I lost my point. So there you go, another example. If you get stunned on anything, you lose your points. So I cover how to gain soul points, how to lose soul points, how to switch between characters, different characters. Holding block will change the characters on your team. Now all that is left is Mystic Arts. To do Mystic Arts, you have to hold your left trigger. I don't know what the key is for a keyboard. Hold left trigger and do some combos, and it will automatically trigger your Mystic Arts. Now Mystic Arts also have different levels to them. Now here you can see Howling Dragon. It is something a higher level of Mystic Arts, and this is a basic level. When you have 3 BG, 3 BG is the minimum for starting a mystic attack. Remember that, and this goes for every character. If you unlock, if you want to do a higher level of mystic attack, you have to perform a combo of 8 hit or higher. To perform that, obviously, as I said, you will need more soul points. I just forgot what I was saying. I believe when you get to end level, you increase your soul point limit to 8 points, so you can do 8 attacks. I believe only then you can manage to solo a 4 BG level Mystic Art. For starters, you just have to rely on this one. So don't get bothered by how you're not able to do this one. Hope I'm clear. If I perform my Break Soul now by doing some as you can see, I performed the Break Soul here and I lost my point. Now Aizen is on 2. So remember that it comes with a cost every time you just spam your R or ref trigger. It comes with that cost. And this enemy which I attacked, as you can see here, it got my soul point. So for a boss type enemy fires, it can be lethal if you're just blindly attacking with your left trigger. Now without further ado, let's just jump into Mystic Arts. How to perform Mystic Arts? Again, just hold your left trigger and do some 2-3 bit through 3 hit combos and it will trigger automatically. Now in case you want to chain them with other characters, do remember they need to have at least 3 BG points. The BG points can be acquired by fighting multiple enemies, by doing multiple fights, random public encounters, and thus you will gain them. And make sure that in strategy you have said that the characters will not use their BG points so that they will not waste it, otherwise they will keep using them randomly and you will never get enough BG points to do Mystic Arts in a boss fight or something. With that much, everything is covered basically. In case you have any doubts, do let me know. How to perform a combo is that, let's say I'm going to do it now. Aizen has 4 BG, so I'm eligible. Velvet also has. Eleanor also has. The Samurai guy also has. Lucifer, everyone has enough. So I'm going to do that now. And with that, how to perform is that, since I'm going to use Aizen, I'm going to keep holding my left trigger, don't let it go, and hit your up for triggering Velvet, down for Eleanor, and side for the rest of the characters. And thus you will trigger a chain. Do remember, keep holding your left trigger, otherwise it will let go. That is a stupid. And that's how 6 attacks are done. And the boss is dead. So hope I'm clear with whatever I said. If you got any doubts, do remember to mention them in the comment. Oh yeah, as you see, I performed my Mystic Art, so everyone got a full bar of soul points, as you could see. So that's one benefit, that every time you do a Mystic Art, your all soul points will get replenished. So do keep in mind that I only use them when necessary, like in boss battle or something. So that's it. This video took a lot of time to make. I mean, you don't know the behind the scenes stuff. every time things went wrong and shit like that, I have to restart it again and again and again. Hopefully this helps someone. If you got any doubts, let me know. I'm still a newbie, but I understood what to do, so hopefully the game from now on will be enjoyable for me. I spent a lot of time to understand because the story is really good, but the gameplay was just smash buttons without understanding what the fuck I was doing. So if you are in the same boat as me, hopefully this video helps. I tried to make this shorter, but the mechanics are so much that it could be too much to shrink it down, or I would have to left things out. I still think I left a lot of things out, but in case you have any confusions, let me know. Until then, thanks for watching and all that stuff. I'll see you in next one in case you subscribe. Thanks for watching.